But for 35 nights, that midnight friend went by her bed and she kept persisting and saying, God, you cannot take this. You cannot allow cancer to devour this lady. And this friend used to tell me, cancer is a dirty disease. It's a wicked disease. She understood the spirit of cancer as she stood by that bed and prayed night after night for 35 nights. That's a long time of praying. And by the 35th day, we were overseas. And as my husband Lalit went by that lady's, Patricia's bed, God said, much prayer has gone. All it needs is an action of faith. And all Lalit did was, said, Patricia, get up, take this little bit of milk. And that's the story of Patricia being free of cancer. And this house, what happened to one, it doesn't end there. When we persist in prayer, the ripples of blessings keep moving far and wide. And since that time, no cancer thrives in this house. And last, every time I speak about this, because I want to comfort the church where church is struggling. And this year when I went overseas, there was a lady, I've never seen her before. She came by me, held my, jacket. And then she said, I want to tell you something. She said, last year when you came to our church and you said this about cancer, you know, she said, her cancer markers were so high. And she was trembling. And she said, she came and told me, I am stricken like this. And so I said, what happened then? She said, you told me, are you submitted to your husband? And she said, no, I am not. And then she said, you told me, go and submit yourself to your husband and your cancer will leave you. And then she said, I did just that. And then she tells me, now I am cancer free. What happened? Well, the blessing in this house, ripples and ripples and ripples, because there was a midnight friend who persisted in prayer. Will you be a midnight friend to someone? Will you get that three loaves of divine bread that you might fill the hunger and the sorrow of somebody else? Someone else's hunger pangs. Not necessarily because they don't have food. The pangs that are in the lives of people. My brothers, my sisters, it's long we've been like this. It's time we spoke out and spoke to our ICOS. Don't let them die away like that starfish. Don't let them be like that boy. Pick up that one that's struggling for life. Given up as hopeless. Pick up that one and fling them through your prayer life into the hands of a loving Father. God is waiting for you to do just that. He's waiting for partnership. He's waiting for those of us who will arise. We'll break the midnight hour and insist and get from God what He has planned for His people. God's plans are always to build up, never to destroy. Let's bring those plans down, the legacy, the inheritance that we have from our Father in heaven. Let's get that down and be a people that need not be ashamed on the day that we have to face our Father in heaven.